shut up, you silly fat cow. You can always wear a hat.
I'm ashamed of her, Doctor. She's an embarrassment. You fancy me?
Not half as much as you fancy yourself.
Forsake me to heaven. You'll take me. Don't try to wake me. I'm just lost in a dream.
How do I feel about coming back to Worthing after 30 years? First of all, it doesn't feel like 30 years. It's very familiar and made me realise how much Wish You Were Here is a Worthing on Sea production. It's very much part of the film. It's very much part of the town, I think.
It's lovely to be by the sea and the dome. I'm pleased that it's still kept some of its character. I'm looking forward to seeing the film. I haven't seen that in a while. And Sarah Radcliffe, the producer, she's here. So yeah, I hope it'd be a nice day.
I'm looking forward to seeing all the performances, seeing great performances in the film. It was a great experience for all of us. We had a great time here. We enjoyed it.
Very, very busy.
Been such a long time.
And the box office is still the same.
We're back. Where the camera goes up.
It was a massive labour of love, celebrating 120 years of filmmaking in Worthing and Shoreham, and it's a real tribute to our town and our heritage, our cinema heritage. So thank you both again so much for your hard work. Thank you. Thank you, David Leland.
You could not be in a more special place for us than the Dome. The film is very much part of Worthing, and Worthing is very much part of the film.
Ladies and gentlemen, Emily Lloyd.
So we were rehearsing the scene, and Lee took it upon himself to direct me, unbeknownst to David. And he said, "You really don't know how to kiss properly. You're not kissing me properly." So I just want to say thanks to Lee Whitlock. I have been perfecting the art of kissing ever since. And thanks again.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much to all the crew and behind the scenes magic people. We never thank you enough.
And at the risk of embarrassing Emily, who is here, I mean, this wonderful casting.
She just stood out, and it was right seeing it today, especially with such a big and enthusiastic audience. I mean, I was very moved at the ending, and Emily's performance is quite superb.
If you're in the film, could you please come down to the front so we can have a photo of all the cast who are here today?
I was in the scene in the cafe when she shouts on the top of the table, and I looked like that. And wherever she was, she put it down, and I grabbed it, because when she
came... I just played Linda when she was younger, and it's wonderful to see the film again. David, congratulations, 30 years, I can't believe it.
I first saw the film at the premiere, actually, which was great fun. It was really a big, big premiere. And
spotted my children and my dogs in the opening scene.
It was a big thing for me. We'd moved to Lancashire and this film came out when I was leaving school as teenagers. Me and a friend, instead of saying up your bum, we turned it backwards and used to say moo boo poo to people.
I was completely involved and emotionally moved, although I knew the film backwards. It was wonderful to see it again. I've got it on video, but of course to see it in the cinema is what you really need to do.
1, 2, 3.
In a dream. You won't forsake me to heaven. You'll take me. Don't try to wake me. I'm just lost in a dream. I'm just lost in a dream.